Okay, you're live.
Okay, we're gonna work on these military wheels here. Everybody says there's supposed to be a stepped hub in here. There's no stepped hubs in these things. I figured they're full of crap anyway. Alright, so we got these all cleaned out, so now we're gonna see how bad they really are. So you can see the pitting in here.
What do you attribute that from?
Rust and wear.
Rust and wear. Well, not surprising.
Hear that?
Yep.
Nail catches on. Can you see it in there at all? If you do a close-up?
Yeah, I believe so. Oh, yeah, it's ugly.
Yeah, but the camera sees it.
Yeah, oh, yeah, you can see it. Yeah.
So this is a really good one here.
So at the speeds we're going with this thing, though, how particular should we be?
It's up to you how bad you want your bike to be.
I'm just saying. And could that be cleaned up any with a...
No, it's done.
...cloth? Okay.
It's heat shirt, it's flaked. Kind of looks like this piece of crap here. That's why we're replacing it.
Okay.
So this here's the other one. So I measured this one here with 2 thou undersize from the new one. See, the new ones are nice and smooth and round.
Very nice, yeah.
This one here is worn. You can see the discolorization. That usually means there's low and it's highs and lows as you go around.
Yeah.
Highs and lows cause chattering. So you like chattering, I hear.
No. Just turn the radio up a little louder.
There you go.
All right.
Louder exhaust. Yeah. What?
You have something to save this.
Huh?
You have something to save that. Rip the wires right out right there.
Buy a new one?
Do you have a new socket?
We'll stop here for a minute. All right, we're back.
We're back. I'm in trouble again.
Yep.
It's all your fault.
No, it's all right. I got broad shoulders.
If you accidentally heard any noise, that wasn't me.
Okay. Okay, we're loading the bearing cages.
I'm doing a test fit.
Okay.
And I'm lazy, so how many am I doing? Every other one. Now don't get in too close.
I'm not. I can see it.
People get pissed and moan that you're too close.
No, you're right there. I want them to be able to read the Timken writing on the roller bearings.
So he fixes taillight wires by giving him a new taillight.
Yeah. Well, that's when you've got junk, sometimes that's the best way to fix it, isn't it?
Yeah.
He wanted vintage. He's got vintage.
There you go.
Sound good to me.
Okay. Not supposed to go on there. There it goes. Now, if you put it on like that, see what happens?
Yes.
See where the roller is?
Yes.
See how it's off the edge of the race?
Yes.
So it's not in the right spot.
Uh-huh.
So it's like that.
Oh, there you go. It picks up the full race.
So now,
yeah,
the cage takes up the dead area and the bearings in the right spot.
Very nice. Okay. Is there a left and right to the hub?
Okay, that was 4/10 over. Does it seem to be a little loose, maybe?
Well, there's some noticeable slop.
See, everybody buys a brand new rebuild kit which has standard bearings in it. They wonder why it...
Yeah, it doesn't work.
Well, they don't even look. They just think it goes together that way, but it's not supposed to be that loose. Okay, now these ones go over here. So you check these independently from each other. And that appears to be really loose. So it may be a shock, but it appears that your hubs are oversized.
Okay.
And you only bought one of them over here. So.
You want them both?
So we're going to have to figure out what this is. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take these out. So these are just about worthless. I should know better to go in the middle of the road. See, you start standing, work your way.
Oh, I see. Okay.
You should have just went right to the big ones.
All right.
Now these are one overs. I used to have some twos at one time, but I think those are all probably gone. Let's see. Yeah, these are all one over. Ooh. We have a limited supply of twos. Now this two is different than the other two by one decimal spot.
Hmm.
That doesn't mean much, does it?
Well, in the world of the machinist, it is. Of which you are.
Okay, so now we take the one over bearings.
like loading a 45.
These are a little smaller though, more like a 22.
Mm-hmm.
Do you like those new screwy guns they use these days that are super light and small?
Right, light caliber.
Instead of 45 to put you on your ass. Okay, so which one are we working on? We're in the big bearing.
Wow, look at that. Way better.
Still pretty damn loose.
But much better than it was.
Mm-hmm. So that's with the used one, the new one.
Mmm. Sweet. That's what we're looking for, huh?
There. That appears to be a little tight.
Yeah.
So we know we're somewhere between these two sizes. So now we have to measure those to see what the difference is. We know there's a thou and a half between the two sides. So how much is it different on this side? Okay, looks like we're just under zero. Well, that's actually pretty close. See, it's worn. So about 3/4 of a thou underside. So that means if we drop these back to the 8/10 or the 6/10 bearing with a new sleeve, it'll tighten this up pretty nicely. If we use the used sleeve, then it'll be used. So now we don't have all the bearings in there, so we're not sure what we need on that. Okay, now we go ahead and check the other side. Appears to be pretty damn loose. Okay, so we know this one's worn a thou and a half. So this one's a thou and a half tighter with the one over bearings, which is 2 thou tighter than stock. So we're still pretty loose. So we're going to have to use a new sleeve on this hub because it's so worn out.
Okay.
Because that other one is just worn too far down. Okay, so we got kind of an idea where we're at on our bearings. So now we go ahead and put all the rollers in here on this one. This one we know is a little bit tight, so I'm going to knock the bearings out a little bit.
How many of these hubs do you think you've rebuilt?
This is my first one.
I was going to say, you seem a little timid. I'm sorry.
But I watched some YouTube videos, so I'm an expert.
There you go, I can tell. When we get you up to 10,000, 100,000.
Okay, so there's that one, so it's not too awful bad. So it's got some nice clearance. It's almost about right, really. See what happens when you do them dry, all the bearings keep falling out.
Yes.
But my fingers don't get gooey.
Gotcha.
There are some pluses. Okay, so now, we know this one here was over. So let's drop back to a 6/10 bearing. In case you wonder how many miles are on it, look at the wear marks on the bottom.
Yes, I can see. Wow.
Mm-hmm. It's called lack of lubrication. And I'm going to go ahead and load all of these because I know it's either going to be this one or the next size up. Now it appears that these used to be 8s and now they're 6s, so that means there's a probably, it says they're 8s over here.
Okay.
They actually measure 6.
Great.
So we know at least we're getting a full 6 on this one. Now most of the time the ones were actually 1 over. But we're not sure about that either right now. Okay, so now we got this one loaded. Spin it around.
Oh, wow.
There's a tight spot right in there. See how tight I'm going this mm-hmm. direction? See, there's not much in there, but there's a lot of this.
Yeah.
So it's pretty tight right in that one spot. So we can either run it and let it wear itself in, or I can drop over to the 6,000s, the 6/10 rollers that are actually 6, that say they're 6, and try those. I have to measure them, which would draw me back a couple tenths. So we'll have to figure out if we want to do that or not. So now that I got kind of a rough idea where I'm at.
I like them tight, I think.
I can go ahead and put this together like this. And see how it feels, actually the way it runs in the motor,
mm-hmm.
or in the wheel in this case. Now see, I put it in the correct direction. See, it's actually loosened up.
Right.
We were on a high spot. The tight spot is this way. See, it's got a little more than it had.
Right.
But it's still pretty tight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now we stick this in and see if it binds it up. And if these rollers are not like this where it's tight. See, yeah. I got to force it in there.
Mm-hmm.
These are all loose. That one's tight. So we have a tight spot there. They don't ride right there, so measure the piece up. See, that rides right there like that.
I see. Of course, the cage is open on this end too. As you force grease in, it goes in. Is that correct?
Well, you lube these all up before you put them together. Okay, so this wheel right now is not as tight as it's going to make it. Everything's right at the minimum. But we have to put the new sleeve over here.
Right.
It turns freely, so it'll wear itself in.
And of course, the grease takes up some also. Is that correct?
Yeah, but you never count the lubricant taking up clearance.
Okay.
It's not made to take up clearance.
I understand.
The thing is, there's no binding going on.
Right.
And you got to make sure you do it while you're... I'm pushing this way with my other finger mm-hmm. over here. Hold that flush. You want to make sure there's no binding. See how nice it turns?
Mm-hmm.
So if it's not binding, even though it's a little tight in a couple spots, I'm not feeling it now.
Gotcha.
Because when I flipped it around the correct way, the rollers now set exactly where they're going to be instead of maybe on a little bit of a high spot.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of being like in this area, it might have been up on the lip.
Right.
Now I drop down in the lower spot, and so I'm not binding anymore.
I see.
So this is nice and free. So we got to use a new sleeve. The full six thou bearing and the one thou bearing. So that's what this hub's going to take.
Wow.
So that's how you check your bearings here to make sure what you got. Now we still got to assemble all up and put in play for shims and all that.
Right.
But at least we got the bearings figured out.
I understand.
They're two different size bearings, so you can't mix them either.
Okay.
So you got to make sure you don't mix your parts. Of course, they're not going to come out easy. They're going to come out in a million pieces. So what I do is I put them in like this, so I don't lose them.
And then I need to go get the other wheel.
First you gotta do all your parts where they belong. There's a washer somewhere. There's the washer. See how it gets picked up some grease in there?
Mm-hmm.
See that washer hits in the thrust sleeve way on
there. Yeah, I see it.
There it is. Actually doesn't go that way. The thrust sleeve is right here, and that's what these washers hit against. This washer flushes, hits it against that. Okay, so we're going to keep this kit here with this wheel.
Okay.
We're going to get out of the wheel.
Okay, we'll be back. Okay, we're back.
Okay, we're on wheel two. He finally got me the good one here. I'm all screwed up like that other one. This one doesn't have all the pitting in it. This one's a nice smooth. It's a good one. Alright, so we're going to take the same one that we just had in the back. I'm just going to lay it in here to get a rough idea where we're at. Appears to be about the same, see? That's a quick mock.
Seems to be tighter, but only because the race is better.
Well, it's smoother, but it's the same problem. It's,
gotcha.
Here's what it is. Now, we used the 1.5 under... I use the old one. I use the new one. So this is the other new one. Yeah, so even though these are smoother, they're worn the same. So we still have the same problem. This one's 1.5 under. And these ones here have the, I think these had the 1/1 bearings on them. So we still can't use this other sleeve. So we're kind of forcing to buy sleeves.
Gotcha.
What? I'm busy.
Here's your other piece back. I like the other one more.
The other what?
I don't know the technical term. I think that goes with my master cylinder.
Okay, well, put it back. Okay, this is looser, see? See how loose it is? So this one here, we're going to use the big bearings on both sides.
Okay.
Put it back in.
Even though we're going to use this on the other wheel for mock-up, quick mock-up, it just told me where I'm at, so now I know where I'm at. So this goes back to the other wheel. So now we're going to go dig through the junk pile over here. Get the cages out we're going to use for this bike. Alright. So now we know we're not using the small bearings, we're going to use the big ones. So I think this wheel is going to wind up using one tile over and everything. Now if you just want a new rebuild kit that has standard bearings in it, that means you'd have 2,000 clearance right off the bat.
Which would not be acceptable.
Yeah. And that's why you have different bearings. Oh, too many. You know, if you do five wheels, see?
Mm-hmm. When was the last time you short a set of these up?
I told you, it's my first one.
Oh, okay. Well, I was going to say.
You don't think I would change my story,
well,
do you?
You don't look too... Well, you look timid on the first one, but I guess not on this one.
Well, technically, it's my second
one. Yeah, all right. I got you. But you have done your own.
I still think it's my first one.
Oh, all right.
I haven't actually finished one yet.
All right, okay. Yeah, as a testament here to all these different bearing sizes. All right, I'm good.
You going to go with that one?
Yep.
Oh.
That's nice.
No, it's too damn tight.
Is it?
I'm pushing on it. I didn't want to come out. I lost one bearing. Okay, so we can't use one overs on that side.
It was right there.
It's on the floor.
Yeah, it's on the rubber, though.
That's all right. See if this works on this one.
Tie two. Nice.
You know, when you get them in there where the wear mark is, they all go evenly. So we're okay on this one.
That's incredible. Metal on metal. You could actually get a tolerance where it wears a track in there. On a roller.
What year are those wheels?
42.
This one, for some reason, felt too loose before, but obviously it's tight because the ones won't work. I think I almost got them all in the right spot.
It's crazy. They're a caged roller bearing, huh?
Yeah.
All right, these are the ones.
Did you find that one?
Yeah, it's right there on the floor.
Okay.
See, cool. I got my safety shoes on.
Gotcha.
I can't afford Fred's safety shoes.
All right.
I got my own.
All right, I got you. But your shop, you do whatever you want, my friend. If they don't like it, they can go down to the shop down the street.
There you go. Okay, so let's see here. We're going to measure these. These ones are Mark 6, but we don't know what size they are.
I may have just enough money to buy some parts.
No, we don't need no parts around here. See, that's a 6. Looks like we don't even have an 8-pack box anymore. 4, 4. There's 4. Four must be six. This one here is a 5.5. So the other one's a half a thou tighter, or not half, a half a tenth tighter. Not that we're very close around here. So these are slightly tighter than the other ones. So let's go ahead and use these ones. So basically we're using the same size bearings on both hubs, which is pretty rare.
Well, that just means it was equidistantly worn out, right?
Yeah, that's it.
Makes pretty good sense. One wheel was following the other one for 70 years.
Is that the secret?
Yeah, I'm guessing.
Sounds like a good plan to me.
Who knows? Who could guess?
The sleeves sure didn't make it the same way.
No, they sure didn't, did they?
One was still usable if it was get a good hub.
Those are both scrap.
Well, one is scrap, the other one's still usable, but it's usable if you had a good hub. The problem is you don't have a good hub, so pretty much makes it foolproof, right? Okay, let's see how this works in here. There it goes.
I like that fit.
It's tight on one side. See, it's all the way in here, it's tighter than that sleeve. Okay, so we're going to have to go with that one on that one. These are all loose on the other side. Checking tool.
Very nice.
Okay.
Wow.
That's your route.
So we got the same bearings, same sleeve. Two different applications. See, I almost got them all back in. It's pretty good for my first time, huh?
You're not that good of a liar.
Am I going for that one?
Hmm.
Ooh, I got all of those one shot. Technically, I guess you can mix them, just you can't experience one or the other.
Gotcha. Hmm. All right, nice.
Okay, so now we got those all together. So now we need to go ahead and do a quick mock-up by, because we want to see if the rims are any good.
Okay.
So I'll just put a light smearing of probably just assembly oil on, lube on, just so they won't be dead dry.
Okay.
And we're going to mock these up with just the parts we got here. And then we got to start to figure out what kind of in-play we're going to need.
Okay.
So yeah, we'll be using a bunch of these newer washers. So let me get that all cleaned up and then we'll
all
get
right
back to it.
Good.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, we're back.
I'm going to figure out what parts we're going to use here. Okay, this cover here is one that was all damaged inside. Can you get a picture of the grooves in there, how deep mm-hmm. they are right there? So the washers were here. Washer's all worn away. Here's a new washer here, so you can see how much is worn away. That was jammed into here.
From rocking back and forth.
Yeah, so that ate up into here. And that's why it was all jammed in. We couldn't get it apart originally. So we had to replace this cover. The washer's obviously trash. So then we got to figure out how bad the other washers are. So these two washers here, got a little bit of wear on the surfaces, but the tits here are still up here where they belong. So we just compare them to an original washer here. And you can see how much wear we got in these things. See how the side of it's all worn away? So that one's junk. See, all of these have a little bit of wear, but it's just a matter of how much wear do you want to tolerate.
Mm-hmm.
See the wear on that one? Yeah, that one looks pretty even, see?
Mm-hmm.
So you want to replace three of them or just two of them?
Well, I guess three of them while we're in here.
That one's got pretty
if
much
those pieces
a lot of worn off
aren't gold, I mean, we want to do it right.
No, they're only $1 million each, so you're
it's okay.
Okay. So here's the other cover we found. This one has a little bit of light wear right here.
Mm-hmm.
Not too bad. With the new washers, we're good.
Okay.
These are the inner sleeves here that go in here. You look for wear on these. These look pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Which is nice. See how smooth they are? Pretty good. They're nice and thick. The problem is they're worn out here where the seal area goes. That's where this was here.
Right. Well, we're not going to be 4 to 18 inches of water.
Because these are all full of dirt and crap.
Yeah,
that was in
just
the seals,
ate them away.
And just ate them all up.
Yep.
Which ate up the washers too. Look how deep this one is.
Yeah.
So they're ate up for different reasons. So we have new ones for those over here.
Oh, wow.
Picked up. So, got you covered.
Nice.
Cost another $1 million.
I knew you would. Well, if it's worth doing, it's worth doing right.
Well.
Wouldn't do any good with new tubes and tires and rubber bands if the bearings weren't any good, would it?
Depends on how fast you want to go.
Well.
You said you didn't want to go very fast.
Well, I'm not a speed demon, but I wanted to ride.
So here's the new ones.
Wow. Very nice.
So they're all undercut in here.
Yeah.
Which lets give you a little place for more grease. So these are later design.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we're going to need three of these now. Good thing I got three of them sitting here. Okay, so that gives us two new washers there and one new one for this guy. Okay, this is going to go on the back wheel with all the bad parts. We always put the worst parts to the rear, to the back wheel.
Okay.
The front wheel has all the best parts because we want to handle the best.
Gotcha.
So this is bad. These are equal. These are new, so they go in the front. These two, one used one goes in the back, so it goes in the back wheel. They're not even new. I've got a bunch of shims in here. These are nice and used. See how,
yes.
See how they get all split?
Oh, yeah.
Where they're starting to come apart?
Mm-hmm.
That's what happens to these things. They get all cracked like that.
Right. Junk.
It's just a matter of time before they come unglued in there. And when they get all bent like this, they're hard to make, you know, it's dragging when they're working.
Right.
So I pretty much replace these pretty much all the time.
Okay.
There's a few of them in here we could probably use, but that's
right.
They're just junk. That's a special one. It goes in a circle.
Right.
So these two here were no good.
So pretty much really everything was junk.
I don't care about mixing bearings because we have all new ones. So this stuff all goes in the trash box too. We are going to figure out what the screws are out there.
Right.
Getting rid of our junk rag now.
So. Right.
Okay, so we got our snap rings. Should be four of them. Make sure they still look good. These are seal retainers. Make sure they're not all chewed up. And these are our thrust washers. They look pretty good too. Now these keep the sleeve from coming out of the wheel.
Okay.
See how they go right there?
Yes.
That's why they get that lip like that. Keeps these from falling out.
Gotcha. Okay. And then you've got a new gasket here.
There's a new gasket, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to do the front wheel first. So we're just going to mock this up for now. We'll be back into this. So we're just going to go and put a assembly lube in here.
See you, Tatro.
See you later.
See you, man.
Take care, my friend. Be careful.
You too. Hey. $200.
Thank you. Here. Okay, so you got a little bit of lube on it. That's all you really need. Couple parts. Gotta put them in correctly this time. So the thrust washer goes in there like that. You have a seal that goes in here. And you have this ring goes like this to hold it.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a snap ring that holds that in.
Gotcha.
Sunglasses.
They're back there on the table.
Yes, they are. Thank you very much.
No problem.
See that keeps the sleeve from falling
out?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't put the seal in there yet.
Gotcha.
We'll do that later. Seal would be this big one right here.
Okay.
Okay. So now this side here, we got our thrust washer goes in first.
Oh, well, you too.
You get your bearings. Rollers are out. Okay, we have our sleeve here. Okay, so we have a thrust washer on this side here in our sleeve. Then we have another thrust washer.
Okay.
Now the reason you got the thrust washers in here like that is this is rotating with the axle because this gets pinched in.
Yes.
These are attached to the wheel because they're dogged in by,
right.
by the teardrop mm-hmm. shape. All your shims and stuff are not rotating. They're pushed solid against the hub.
Gotcha.
They only spin on the inside edge.
Gotcha.
That's why they have the big hole in them.
Right.
So you got to make sure you put together that direction like that. So it goes in like that. You have a gasket supposed to be in here. The tit obviously has to line up with the tit.
Right.
Like that. And you bolt it together and then you see how much inflow you got. Now right now with all new parts, with no gasket, see the inflow, I got about 10 or so in there, 10 mm-hmm. or 12. So when you go to put it together, you're gonna have probably three washers in there. And then you have to measure this gasket thickness
and,
add,
seal.
And add that much more.
Okay.
And that'll give you an idea of how much you have in there. Now, right now, we're gonna put this thing together with nothing because we're gonna do, we wanna check the wheel, the trueness of the wheel. Okay, now this up here, your wheels had screwed up holes in some of these. You had all these incorrect screws in here?
Yes.
So these are the correct thread right here?
Yes, much different.
Can you
yes.
see a difference?
Oh, of course.
So this up here appears to have the good threads in it. So I'm going to take a couple of these. Now for mock-up, we only need three screws. It appears we have three screws.
I think I have a pack of those new.
I bought you new ones.
Okay.
And I even ordered up the coarse thread ones for the other hub because they cross-threaded all the coarse ones.
Okay.
Where did that run off to?
I didn't hear it drop. Oh, there it is.
Two of them. So the front wheel, we got the correct threads in the hub. The back wheel is the one that's all screwed up. And the back one's the one that had the bead locks in it. The front one doesn't. So we got to determine if you want to keep the bead locks in there or just weld the holes up.
Well,
or if the rim's bad or not. We don't even know if the rim's bad.
Yeah, we don't even know.
So we have to make some decisions.
We're hoping.
That. We're hoping it's bad?
No, we're hoping that it's good.
Oh.
Or we're hoping that you can pull a rabbit out of your hat. I'm guessing
out of my
you,
what?
Out of your hat. I didn't say that other thing. And I know you will.
Okay, so now we have some inflow in here. See the inflow?
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Okay, so now we can actually.
But we're all shimmed up. Yeah.
We can put this in the trueness stand and see how good it is.
Okay, great.
That's the important part.
Okay.
Here's the factory tool.
That substitutes the axle.
Substitutes the axle sleeve. See, the sleeve is mm-hmm. here, goes in here normally.
Mm-hmm.
So it picks up the thing, pops in there.
Oh, yeah.
And that just goes over and just ties up against this part. See how it has a shoulder in it?
Mm-hmm.
Here's a cover that. See, that's for recessing inside of
oh,
here.
Oh, yeah.
So you don't mm-hmm. damage these.
Sure.
And I'm not putting them in right now because I'm not done with the hub. I just want to see if the wheel's any good. So that's the factory part.
Nice.
So now you can put it in the factory chewing stand. Just down here. It all fits in. You have to take out the bogus arbor in here, though.
Okay.
This is bogus arbor. It's used for modern crap. Then we got to adjust it over to where the thin ones are out here. Because we got to narrow this
up. Gotcha.
I notice this has parkerized washers. Yes. In it still.
Very nice. Original.
Yep.
Wonder where the original bench that was on came from, where it ended up.
I don't think we ever had it with a bench.
Okay. Come on, baby.
So once you get the right width, you go ahead and tighten it down. Go. Some twist locks on the axle retainer. Okay, now you can see how bad everything
is. Shit, it's perfect.
Oh yeah, look at that. It's almost perfect. Yeah. Look at that.
Yeah. Yeah, not good. What are we gonna do?
Well, it's only the front wheel. It's not that important, is it?
No. No, not in the least bit.
So we have to do a little bit of work on this wheel.
Think we could get it to come back?
Well, the first problem is, are these going to move?
Yeah. There's a factory nipple wrench, I'm sure.
Yep. Is it ready, Altino? You mean the one that looks like this?
Mm-hmm.
I have a sneaking suspicion that these spokes are going to break before they move.
Are they twisting?
Because that nipple just kind of rounded. It's not moving.
What about if we put a little lube here on the...
A little bit of lube?
Well, I'm just thinking, would that help at all? Well, you got it.
No, that was the other one. I'm thinking we're going to have some issues with these.
Yeah, I'm guessing so.
It seems like every other one. Well, we just screwed that up because we're out of phase. There, that one moved. Yeah, we got two in a row. Not that one. Not that one. Not that one.
Not that one either.
So what you got to do if you're trying to save this stuff... We have to go in there with a torch
and heat
these things up, put some wax and stuff in there to try to get the thread to break it through, or you get to put some like Kroll in there, some really good rust penetrant.
Right.
And you try to break them free and without
try to save
without destroying the nipples.
But that should go.
And you try to make it work like that. Okay. Otherwise, you cut all these things out and you put new stuff on it. And then you got to make a decision about what do you want to do on the rim. So the first thing you got to do is try to get the rims straightened out enough to see if we can save it.
Right.
Right here, it's got a big flat spot right there.
Yeah.
You can kind of feel like right in here where it really...
Well, what would you do?
I take a big hammer and I beat the hell out of these. See that rubber one up there?
Yeah.
Easy bigger than that.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I got you. Steel on steel.
No. Big lead one.
Oh, really? Okay.
Or you put it in the press and you crush it.
Got it.
And you try to see if you can save the original rim because I like using the original rim.
Yeah, I know you do. All right. So, well, a little heat strategically placed would help.
And if you get the rim squared up enough that you can run the rim, then you can just cut the spokes down to get some new spokes. and get some black parkerized ones. They're supposed to be parkerized anyway, not painted.
Oh, okay. I'm guessing they sandblasted those wheels.
You think?
Yeah, well, they were probably uglier than shit.
Probably. So, the front wheel, we know where we're at on that, which is, I'm really shocked that the spokes don't move.
No, you're not. I'm not surprised in least bit.
Okay, so we know this one, what we got now.
Needs help, all right.
But the key is the hub is good. That's very important.
Yeah, okay, good.
That's very important. Okay, so now, get this out of the way someplace. You know, we used to have a couple benches opened up around here at one time. Okay, so now we got to move on to the other wheel.
Hold on here just a minute. I'm going to shut this down for just a sec.
Okay. All right. We on?
Yes, we're back.
Got to find the missing washer there. Okay, I already lubed it up here already. Okay, same deal. The bearings always go out, not in. So it goes like this. Press washer doesn't really need to be in there, but screw it. Dirt in there for some reason. Almost don't need things. Got away from me there.
It's okay, as long as it didn't hit you in the eye.
Oh, I would never do that.
How's your finger feeling?
Still got a red line on it. You don't think I hit that very hard, do you?
Oh, man. Could have been disastrous.
Nah.
Yeah.
I'd never do anything dangerous around here. It wouldn't be like that finger there, would it?
Oh, man.
See, it still got the red line across it.
Yeah, well, it's not black and blue. It could have broken it right off.
Yeah,
that's what it gets when it gets wound up in a mill.
Jammed in a couple things, that's all right. Didn't even hurt. I don't think I was dangerous at all.
Jeez.
See, we have all the fun off the video, see? Nobody's gonna know what we did. It's a secret. Okay, washer, sleeve, washer, retainer, crappy wrong screws.
Are we going to have to retap those?
No, it's already been, the hub has already been committed to
coarse
thread, so it's no longer quarter 24, it's quarter 20 now.
Okay.
That's why I got you those correct looking screws and the wrong thread. I surely hell I'm not putting these ugly ass screws back in.
No.
Man.
Make your own threads.
Damn. Hey, that one made it. Pretty equal.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Amazing how these things repeat so close. Now, if you don't have this retainer to keep the sleeve in here, the sleeve will fall out.
Gotcha.
And the bearings will fall out on the other side.
Okay.
That's why I went to trouble to put that in there.
Okay.
See, this stuff, I don't need any of this other crap on here for trucking. Right. That's why it's out. You learn the tricks over the years, what you need and don't need.
Mm-hmm.
We already got this set up, so
okay.
Put this right in. Backward depreciates this for you. appears to be out of balance.
Yeah, it wants to roll. That's never a good sign.
It wants to be right there.
Yeah.
Oh, that's like almost perfect.
Yeah. Yeah.
Of course, the tire bead's really good on that.
Yeah, yeah. Well, sure.
Corrosion there.
Sure. Well, who knows how long it's sat.
It appears to have the same issues. Yeah.
So are you just recommending getting a whole new set of spokes? That would probably be the better way to do it.
Well, yeah, a new set of spokes, and the rims are going to be pretty hard to save the rims.
So then we're just basically
I don't really want to use reproductions, but the problem is I bought something on eBay that looks just like this.
Yeah, well, that's all you're going to get, huh?
The same crap. And that one's going to be hard to... It's got a pretty good one in there. The problem without being able to play with the spokes, you can't get it that close.
Well, a little bit of heat would definitely fix it.
It definitely, from here to here, it really drops in. It's over a large area.
Yeah.
So unless these spokes are really tight, they're not. See, that's
right.
Loose.
Right.
Not very tight. Not very tight. Loose. So it's not from these being super tight, making this whole rim flat.
Right, right. Mm-hmm.
This whole thing has been hit right here pretty heavy, mm-hmm. bent in. And so you can true up a little bit of this stuff, but if the spokes would work, I could probably get half of that out of there, but I don't know if I get them all out.
Well, so then you're thinking we should probably just do that, at least try.
And I'm not sure if the stupid-ass import rims are any better than these.
No, I'm guessing they're not.
So that comes down to trying to find some good original ones, which is pig in a poke. You don't know what you're buying. You're
right.
You can buy this wheel on eBay for $250 and thought you had a good wheel, and you take it apart and you find it's like, these junk.
Yeah, well, of course. Why wouldn't it be?
Yeah, so.
They're all the same.
Yeah,
well, then how about we just stick with what we've got here and just do the best we can?
There are better ones, but...
I mean, I know you're land speed record holder, but I don't plan on going 70, 80, or 90, or 100 miles an hour.
Yeah, well, we just have to see what we're going to do. We'll figure out something here.
All right.
Okay. But anyway, we know where we're at right now. We didn't know until we got it together.
Nice.
But at least we got two hubs that are decent. So.
Right.
The rest of this stuff is pretty much we need to do something about.
Okay.
So we'll make some decisions.
Good. Thanks.